the enterovirus 68 epidemic, which infected thousands of children this fall, was likely spread through America by President Barack Obama's decision to allow millions of Central Americans across the Texas border, according to a growing body of genetic and statistical evidence that has been collected. The evidence includes admissions from top health officials that the epidemic included multiple strains of the virus, and that it appeared simultaneously in multiple independent locations in the United States. The question would be settled if federal researchers study the genetic fingerprint of the enterovirus 68 that first hit kids in Colorado, Missouri, and Illinois to see if they are close relatives to the FD68 viruses found in Central America. One 9-year-old child was diagnosed with the enterovirus in early October. Officials have to do the genetic analysis to disprove or prove the link, Nora Chapman, an enterovirus scientist. But there's already lots of statistical evidence for American citizens to demand that scientists test the viruses to see if Obama's progressive border priorities spread the dangerous contagion throughout the country during 2014. So far, that virus has been found in 9 American kids who died from illness, has apparently inflicted unprecedented polio-like paralysis in roughly 50 kids, and has put hundreds of young American kids into hospital emergency wards and intensive care units throughout more than 40 states. Call Obama now and demand answers to the question, has his border policies put Americans at risk? Call 202-456-1414 now. These rules are intended to tighten restrictions on the federal government from using without compensation assets and resources on pilot property. A personnel permit for entry by each federal official can be obtained by applying for a limited access permit by sending a request for a permit to Highland Hill Farm at 5275 West Swamp Road, Fountainville, Pennsylvania, 18923, and enclosing an application fee of $1 million. No application will be considered unless a full detailed letter explaining what the access will entail. Date of entry, date of exit, and a biosecurity plan for pathogen control is enclosed. The application shall as enclosed a $10 million bond to ensure that all of Highland's environmental regulations are followed. Further, all federal agents must show proof of a current background check and proof they are covered by a workman's liability insurance policy. All federal agents must follow guidelines set forth under Highland Hill Farms Biosecurity Plan in wear full protective suits to prevent contamination of Highland's properties. Any federal agent who enters Highland's properties needs to have a separate vehicle entrance permit, which is available after obtaining a personal permit. All permit applications must include a sworn statement under penalty of perjury that all information is correct and signed by the applicant and his direct supervisor. All applicants must personally agree in writing to be liable for any damages they incur while on Highland's properties and agree to a hold harmless clause that Highland drafts. Applications shall be reviewed within 6 months and Highland reserves the right to extend the application review time for an additional 6 months. Under Pennsylvania Act 125 of 2010, U.S. government agents and the federal government will face trespass charges and be responsible for any economic damages Highland incurs due to the failure to observe posted biosecurity measures or damages to Highland Hill Farm properties plus civil damages. Highland reserves the right to reject any or all applications for any reason.
This video is brought to you by Highland Hill Farm. We grow and sell screening and buffering trees for privacy and sound barriers.